Hallmark, everyone. Our walls are back up, and next, tackle paint. Now, choosing a color is never really that easy, but it's always so much fun. And with the huge array of colors and shades Benjamin Moore Paint has to offer, we can't wait to test some out and find that perfect fit for the heart of our home. I'm talking about right here, our family room.
This is going to be a lot of fun.
Yes.
I love painting so much. But before we start painting, we would love to announce something that everyone has been waiting for all week long, including us. And that is which entertainment center we decided on. So remember, we had three different choices.
Yep.
We had the floating glass shelves.
Right.
We had the wainscoting or the sliding wooden doors. So after much deliberation, we went with the wainscoting.
You know,
come on. That's
it looks good. I think it's a good choice. It fits with the overall architecture of the house. Yes. And what's really nice about it, it gives us free rein when it comes to color. Because with the wood ones, we'd have to consider the wood tones, with the glass and all that. That gives us complete free rein for our next step.
And the truth is, it's going to add a lot of elegance and beauty to our family room.
Right.
And my favorite thing about it is I don't think it will fit a 100-inch.
Well, that remains to be seen.
I don't know if you noticed that.
That remains to be seen. I'm not ruling it out yet, Deb. I'm not ruling it out. Okay, we've got that selected. Now let's get back to the paint. This is very exciting because the tone of the room really depends largely on the paint. And I love that we're using Benjamin Moore paints because they have such depth to them.
Mm-hmm. And that's what's really important. I've said this before. When you're picking a color for a room, you don't want to pick a color that has a single note. You want colors that have multiple tones and hues. And so different times of day, you're like, is that blue? Is that gray? Is that, you really want that. And Benjamin Moore has such a huge variety of colors that you can really pick all of these wonderful subtle tones. So when you're getting everyone's opinion, your spouse's, your wife's, your wife's friend, your wife's friend, you've got some options to discuss.
The mailman, the dog, anybody who has an opinion has an opinion. Okay, not only do they have a huge array of colors, they also have a huge array of sheens, which, by the way, the sheen of a paint can also change the feel and the look of a room. So what you've done here, Ken, I want to show everybody, you took the same color paint, same color, but with different sheens, and you put it on this board so we could see just how different they all are.
Exactly. It's very important. This is the same color. It's a deep, deep navy color with four different sheens. Now, for those of you at home who don't know, sheen is the amount of shine, and it goes from basically zero to a lot, as you can see here. We start off with flat, which has no sheen at all. It really absorbs light and gives you rich color.
I see that.
It's the least durable of them, but it's also the easiest to touch up because you can go through and cover up and it will blend right in. This is good for low traffic areas, adult rooms, things like that.
Okay.
The next is eggshell, which is a tiny bit more sheen. This would be appropriate for things like a kitchen where your pasta sauce is splattering, a kid's room, or high traffic areas like a hallway. A little bit more.
Okay.
Pearl is probably middle of the road. You've got a little bit more sheen on the pearl. So it's good for really high traffic areas or also for things like trim around doors, windows, and that sort of thing.
Okay.
The most sheen and the most durable is going to be your semi-gloss.
Got it.
And that's really reserved for things like baseboards where you're going to be kicking them or around windows and things like that. And that's going to also give you that nice pop because of that sheen. Colors really look great.
It's a great illustration of
that.
Okay. It's amazing because they look like different colors, don't they?
Yeah,
it's the same color. And you can see that sheen.
So what do you think for this room, Ken?
For our room, because it's not high traffic, I think we should go with flat. It's really going to let us pick a rich color that we're really going to see that, and we don't necessarily have to worry about durability in this room.
Okay.
And we do little touch-ups in with the flat.
Exactly.
Touch-ups. Okay, we've got the sheen picked out, which is very important. Now it comes to the actual color of the room. You're going to help us decide that color. Here's an issue that I've had through the years. Maybe people can relate to this, is that the color on the little paint swatch, the little piece of paper that you're choosing, never really is exactly the same as how it ends up on the wall.
It's completely different, by the way, because you're looking at this big versus a ginormous wall.
You can't, and people are like, this isn't the same color. It's not, and you put it up, it's like, it is. Yeah. It's going to change because of the light in your room and the sort of what color carpet you have and that sort of thing.
Yeah.
So what you really want to do is go pick out your top three or four colors, buy a small pint of it, and actually get a big swatch up on your wall, and then live with it. Live with it through 24 hours, through day, night, because it's also going to change with the lights on versus the daylight.
And it's interesting how your brain changes, too. Like, you'll put it on the wall. I did this at my parents' house, and then I walked down the next morning and thought, oh, my gosh, why don't you choose that?
Right, it changes. Yeah. So put it up and let it sit. So I've chosen three colors here for us to sort of choose from that'll give very different moods within the room.
Okay.
Okay.
Our first color, are you ready? It's called Baltic Sea.
Oh my gosh, I love it.
That's beautiful.
Now, it's going to give a very kind of cool feel to the room.
All right.
Sort of a very kind of classic, not quite Mediterranean, but in that same, you know, more Baltic than Mediterranean.
Okay, I love it, but it's close.
And we want to put a big swatch so we can really see.
This is very bright and airy. Yeah. I like this, considering that, you know, Cameron got his entertainment center, but according to Brett, I won't be getting my window, so perhaps this will give us a little more light.
I do. I got to see, seeing it up on the wall, I totally agree with you.
Beautiful?
I get this light, airy feel. It looks fantastic.
You know, and I think, especially, you know, in our California thing with all with the outside, it feels very indoor, outdoor.
Okay, what if we wanted something a little warmer, though?
So let's go with something in the warm spectrum. In the warm spectrum, I picked a color here called Fire Glow.
Look at that.
Okay.
It walks that line between sort of a terracotta and an orange and a brown, sort of with those sort of multi-tones that Benjamin Moore is so good at. It really sort of gives us a different sort of feel.
Gosh, they are really beautiful colors.
Yeah.
Like sitting by a fire.
Yeah,
exactly. Like a warm Christmas morning, opening your presents by the fire.
Love it.
You're all like bundled up in your sweaters, fresh in from the ski slopes.
Yeah, can you imagine our Christmases with that color? It'd be great. So I get the benefits of having like a cooler, more airy color, and also as well, of course, a warm, cozy color.
It's interesting because these paint colors really do set the mode for your family and for your house.
They
you
really
talk
do.
About festive versus cozy.
And here's
it makes a big difference.
Here's what I'm thinking, though, too. Because we change out the decorations for the seasons here so much, we're changing so many different elements of our family room. What about going with a more neutral tone?
Well, neutral is what we've always gone with in the past.
Okay.
We've had accent walls of red at one point or another, but this beige sort of off-white is generally considered a neutral. Things have changed a little bit, and darker colors are considered neutral. So now grays, some browns, even blacks are considered neutral. So I did want to give us that option, and I've chosen a gray. Now, Benjamin Moore has grays that have wonderful undertones of pinks, blues,
greens.
Yeah,
there's so many different color grays, by
the way. Exactly. So this is one called Soho Loft.
I like that one.
Which is a standard gray, but it does have an ever so slight little blue-purple tint, which I think warms it up to keep it from feeling like a battleship. You don't want to feel like you're
Right.
And that's what those extra tones do to give you that sort of extra feel.
Okay, I'm gonna say this. I love this color so much because with the furniture we're gonna put in here, it's not gonna compete. It's gonna let our furniture pop.
It'll absolutely
will
do that. And these will lighten a little bit as they dry too. You gotta remember
they
that.
They will lighten, right. And we're doing flat, so there won't be a sheen once they do. So we didn't like sit with it, feel it.
We got some options.
You know what, listen, the truth is, these are all beautiful options, and no matter which Benjamin Moore color we choose, every single one of them is going to be a different feel, but equally as beautiful.
Right.
I mean, I don't know how we're going to choose, because I do like, at first I was like, oh, of course, and then now, I have, and now I'm very confused.
You know what we need?
We need some other opinions.
We need some help.
We need some other opinions, for sure. Go to HallmarkChannel.com, everyone, all of you. Give us your opinion on what paint you like best. And every time you'll be entered into Hallmark Channel's Renovation Fever Sweepstakes for a chance to win the grand prize of $50,000. And, by the way, and $1,000 worth of Benjamin Moore paint and supplies. So go tell us what you like. You like the cool, you like the warm, or the neutral paint. Let us know.
I match.
It matches your dress and Cameron's eyes.
Yeah.